Dave Palumbo with another RX Muscle Rant brought to you by Redcon One. Today's topic, cramping. I know a lot of you guys out there have this problem. Contest season is right in the midst of going on. We have the Olympia coming up in 2 weeks. And, you know, you never know what can happen. You cramp. I hear people all the time complaining of cramping, whether it be on stage, whether it be at night, at bed, you know, when they go to bed, whether it be, you know, in the gym. And there's a lot of different reasons for cramping. You know, in my bodybuilding history, there's been three specific times I can remember actually cramping. One, which was is a common, you know, occurrence, was at a show. When I used to do diuretics leading up to my shows, I used to use aldactone for a couple days, and then I would add diazide in. And I realized that was a terrible, you know, and obviously you hear me talk about that all the time, not a good idea. Well, it wasn't a good idea back then, and I learned the hard way, because what would happen is usually about a day or two out from a show, but usually the day of weigh-in. So let's say weigh-in was like on a Thursday, and I was competing on a Saturday. Usually about 2 days before show, I'd already start cramping, and that's not a good sign, okay? And usually the cramping is due, obviously, to, if you're taking aldactone at least, it's due to a sodium depletion. And that's because you're not taking in enough salt. That was another thing I did. I depleted salt for more than one day. Big mistake, and I've corrected that. I don't use aldactone. I don't restrict sodium in my clients' diets until the day before. And there's a lot of different changes I made because of that. And that's an easy fix. You know, you put sodium back in. Now, a lot of times guys will also cramp in hot, you know, environments. I cramp sometimes when I go to Vegas, because you don't even realize that you're dehydrating, because the heat is so dry there that it just evaporates right off your body. So you don't see yourself sweating, but yet you're losing tons of fluid. You can feel it, and your mouth gets dry, your lips get dry, your eyes. I have wear contact lenses, my contacts get dry. And when you dry out fluid-wise, usually, you know, you're losing sodium as well. And if you're not consuming a lot of salt, I try to eat a lot of salt when I go to Vegas, because that helps you hold water and stay hydrated, you cramp, okay? So the most commonly caused cramp you would get would be a sodium depletion cramp. And so usually when people tell me, hey, I'm cramping, I just started your diet, Dave, and whenever you eat a low-carb diet, obviously you deplete more water. When you deplete water, you deplete sodium with it. So that's the usual reason, you know, that you do. And that's another reason why I tell people to consume a lot of salt. You know, Stan Efferding and I had an interview the other day, and he's such a big believer in salt that he actually has people like drink salt, you know, salt water, essentially, to super hydrate themselves and super salt load themselves, especially before working out. Now, if you eat salt on a regular basis and you salt your foods, then you don't really have to do that. But there's some people that just don't like the taste of salt, and they have to kind of drink it down, you know, any way they can get it. I mean, there is sodium in like Gatorades and stuff like that, but there's obviously sugar in there, but it's not a ton, you know. I used to, when I would compete, I was literally bottles of soy sauce on food. I mean, I would just crave it because I used to sweat so much. And that's something good. A lot of people are afraid of salt. They almost equate salt to being heavy or having fat on their body. And they actually think that if they cut sodium while they're dieting, they're going to lose weight better. Remember, it's not weight loss we're going for. We're going for fat loss, okay? So just because you're dehydrating yourself, I have a couple of clients, they were like, should I be in the sauna now? At 4 or 5 days out, I'm like, what is being dehydrated 5 days out going to, how's that going to help you for the show? You need to lose a little more body fat. And when we need to get the water out of you, we'll get it out of you the last day. So, because cramping is a real thing. Remember, if you're like even like something like 5 or 10% dehydrated, your exercise performance will drop over 20% because of that. So, sodium, you know, levels in the body and hydration, which kind of go hand in hand with each other, okay, are really important to the exercising athlete. Now, granted, on a bodybuilding stage, we're really not performing, you know, we're not lifting weights. We're not running, you know, the 100 meters. So a little dehydration on a bodybuilding stage doesn't really matter. But in the gym while you're working out, absolutely matters, because you're not going to be able to perform optimally. Plus, dehydrated muscles tend to be very catabolic muscles. So you want to make sure you get enough salt in your diet on a daily basis, okay? And that's throughout the day. You can't just have it once in the morning, you know? Make sure you salt your foods. There's nothing wrong with that. Okay, now, if you're on blood pressure medications like prescription diuretics for blood pressure, which I would hope a lot of bodybuilders wouldn't have to take, that's more of like an older person's type of blood pressure control, then you got to restrict sodium. Because if you eat a lot of salt when you're on a diuretic, it kind of counteracts the diuretic. You know, it doesn't allow the diuretic to do its thing. The second type of cramp would be what I'd call a potassium depletion cramp. Now, why would you become potassium depleted? Well, you could either be taking a diuretic that's not potassium sparing, like a Lasix or a Demodex. Okay, maybe you've depleted too much potassium, so the cramping could be caused by potassium loss. More likely than not, people during regular life or during their regular type of routine who start cramping and who are actually potassium depleted, the only time that would occur is if you're throwing up. So if you have a virus or you're food poisoning and you're puking, okay, and you're vomiting, you're going to lose a lot of potassium, okay? And if you're cramping in that situation, I would probably say that that's potassium related, and I would try to supplement with some kind of a potassium supplement. Once again, you don't want to excessively use potassium because that's not good for you either, okay? Salt is a lot easier. If you eat too much salt, your body basically just urinates it out. You pee it out. Too much potassium can go into the bloodstream and raise, potassium levels too high. That can cause a problem. Okay, we don't want to do excessive sodium and potassium. So don't knee-jerk say, I need potassium if you're cramping. Like I said, more than likely, it's a sodium depletion cramp. If you're vomiting or throwing up, different story, okay? You could eat a couple bananas, which will settle your stomach anyway, which will be good for you. Bananas have a lot of potassium in them. You could take a potassium supplement. They do sell them out there. Usually they're limited in dosage to 99 milligrams. But there's ones you can get that's a little higher than that. But once again, I wouldn't recommend, if you're that potassium depleted because you've been throwing up for 3 days straight, you should probably go to the doctor, let them put an IV in you and replace the electrolytes that way. The third way I see people cramp are what I would call clenbuterol cramps. Okay, a lot of people use the prescription drug clenbuterol, which is an asthma medication, to burn body fat. Okay. And it happens to have a terrific fat-burning effect. The problem is that clenbuterol makes the muscles contract really hard, okay? Increases contractility of the muscles. That's why when people take clenbuterol, they notice they get stronger. Even though they're maybe in a dieting state, they're like, wow, I'm actually stronger. I don't know why. It's from the clenbuterol, because it makes the muscles contract harder. The problem is, because they contract harder, they tend to sometimes get stuck. Now, if any of you have ever taken clenbuterol and you yawn, sometimes when you yawn, the muscles under your neck here, you'll get like little cramps in here, and you don't know what it is. It's like, ooh, it's a weird feeling because you're not used to that muscle cramping. That's very common with clenbuterol. Hamstring, calves, your pecs locking up after a chest workout, very common with clenbuterol. Not everyone gets them, okay? Some people do. Usually most people will get the little yawning ones, and they open their mouth too wide, and because when you stretch that muscle too much, it causes it to contract and lock. The best way to combat that is to go to the supermarket and buy what's called diet tonic water, okay? The diet, you don't want to get the regular tonic water because that has sugar, but diet tonic water is like a sucralose-based, flavoring system. But the tonic water contains methylquinine. Methylquinine prevents cramping, okay? So you take that, even in like 2 to 4 ounces of it, a little drink of it, it doesn't taste too bad. It's fizzy. When you're dieting, it probably tastes delicious. People buy tonic water to mix into drinks, drinks you would get at a bar, they make with that. But this, you could just get diatonic water, you can just drink a couple ounces, and it will release the cramps, and it'll prevent the cramping. Now, some people have asked me, well, that's great, that's a great idea, maybe I should take that, when I go to my bodybuilding show, so I don't cramp on stage. Yeah, it's a great idea. The problem is, if the cramp is being caused by a lack of sodium in the muscle, okay, masking that effect is not good because it's going to make your electrolyte balance get worse and worse and worse, and you're not going to correct it. If you're backstage and you're cramping, you could take a teaspoon of salt and about an ounce of water and drink that down, and then 15 minutes later even do it again if you need to, and that usually corrects the problem because now you're restoring sodium. If you just take something that masks the cramping and prevents it, and you're slowly progressively getting more and more sodium depleted, you'll probably wind up in the hospital, okay? Because you can stop your heart. I mean, you can get cramps in your intercostal breathing muscles. Your diaphragm could cramp theoretically. You don't want your sodium levels getting too low, because eventually it will catch up with you. You want, a lot of people don't realize pain, things that go on in your body. These are not meant to be there to make you guys miserable. They're warning symbols. They're your body talking to you, essentially, and you got to learn the language of your body. If it's telling you something is not right, okay, and you're getting cramps or you're getting pain someplace, you need to address that, okay? Because that's your body saying to you, hey, dummy, wake up. You know, you're in trouble. I want you to fix this problem. We're not going to do too well if you don't fix this problem. So yeah, don't take diatonic water backstage. Know how to diagnose your cramping problem. If you're taking if you're not taking a potassium sparing diuretic, if you're taking a diuretic like Demodex, like I said, or Lasix, where you lose sodium and potassium, it makes it trickier. How do you fix the problem backstage? That's why I don't recommend those diuretics. I always recommend diazide because it's potassium sparing. If something goes wrong, you know it's a sodium cramp. Anyway, I hope this cleared up a few things. A lot of people always ask me about cramping and what they should do about it. And these are things that are, you know, that you can do. The first thing you always do is add salt to your diet. If that doesn't solve this cramping problem and you're not throwing up, then it could be just a case of hypercontractility of the muscles. If you're using clenbuterol, that could be the problem. Some people just cramp, you know, but I always find it's usually due to sodium. Now, there are some instances, very rare, where people cramp because they don't have enough calcium and or magnesium in the body. And magnesium is a relaxant also. So you could sometimes before bed, if you get these night cramps and you know you're taking enough sodium in, try to take a magnesium supplement before bed. You know, they have these liquid ones that are really good. That could relax you. I like to take calcium with magnesium. If you use my V-mineralize multivitamin, multimineral formulation, you'll probably never have to worry about, you know, having a deficiency of magnesium or calcium because it's very high in both of those minerals and they're chelated, which means they're super absorbable, bound to amino acids. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed this little rant. It's not as much a rant as it's an educational video. I just wanted to put it out there because we're in contest season. You might want to, you know, you might run into some of these issues, and now you got the solutions. I'm Dave Palumbo for another RX Muscle Redcon 1 rant.